Bachchan, in ongoing video lectures of this subject, we had learned data transfer, arithmetic and logical instructions of 8085. And today I will be going to explain next category of instruction set, that are branch and program control instructions. In this session, we will cover the following topics like basics of branching instructions, what are conditional and unconditional branching instructions, and jump, call and return instructions. So first, how works these instructions in processor? The branching instruction alter the normal sequential flow. In this type of instruction, the control of program is transferred from one location to another location. These instructions alter conditionally and unconditionally. Further, two possibilities are there, true or false. In conditional branch instructions, these instructions are dependent on status of flags except auxiliary carry flag and affected for previous ALU operations. When condition as status of flag is checked, two possibilities are there, first true or false. When condition is true, the controller is transferred to 16-bit address and execution continues. And when condition is false, the controller program is transferred to very next instruction. In unconditional control transfer instructions, the controller program is transferred to 16-bit address unconditionally. Means the execution control is transferred to the specific location of any status or condition. Example of branching instruction are jump, call and return. For example, jump 5060 hex means controller transfer to 5060 location instead of sequential execution. Let's take one example to understand how jump instruction works. So when a program is executing, its instructions are located in main memory. The PC means program counter contains the address of a next instruction to be executed. For example, it is 3040 hex. This instruction is fetched into the processor and is prepared for execution. In the middle of the machine cycle, the PC is incremented to 3041 so that it points to the instruction that follows the just one fetched. Then the fetched instruction is executed and the cycle repeats. The instructions are automatically executed in sequence. When a jump instruction executes, for example, jump 5060 hex. So it puts a new address 5060 into the PC. Now the processor fetches the instruction from that new address, follows the jump instruction in memory instead of executing the instruction in sequential manner. Before the PC changes, the instruction that follows the jump instruction in memory is fetched and executed. Means before any change, PC is 3040 hex, it is executed. After that instruction executes, the next instruction to execute is the one that was jumped to, means control transfer to 5060 hex location. Call and return instructions, that are type of branch instructions used to execute subroutine, and these instructions with example we had covered in our previous video of this tutorial series. Now next category is conditional jump. Now see, we have flags like 0, sign, parity, carry and auxiliary carry in 8085. When conditional jump instruction is executed, first of all, processor will check status of flags whether it is true or false. Depending on the status or condition, control of execution will transfer to specified location. For example, here we will take 0 flag. If 0 flag is 0, means not set, means result is not 0. Then jump if not 0 instruction is used, and Z flag is set, means result is 0. Then jump if 0 instruction is used. Next category is carry flag. If carry flag is 0, means not set, then jump if not carry address instruction is used, and carry flag is set, means carry occurred, then jump if carry instruction is used. Now we will take parity flag. and if parity is odd means it is zero, then jump if for instruction used, and if parity is even means it is set, then jump if even instruction used. Next is send flag, and if result is positive means send flag is zero, then jump if positive means JP instruction used, and if result is negative means it is one, then jump if minus means JM instruction is used. All this used to understand conditional jump. So as you can see here one scenario in which number of instructions are listed with locations. First instruction XRA A that performs logical XOR operation between A and A data on location 4000X, and A has data FFX. After execution of this instruction, result stored in accumulator and that is 00X. So affected flag is 0 and modified 0 flag is 1. Now next instruction on location 4001 is jump if 0 means ZZ 5000X. Before transferring control to 5000 address, it will check status of 0 flag and it is 1. Then control will transfer to 5000 location. In our case, after executing XRA instruction, accumulator is 0, so 0 flag is set, so condition is true and jumps to 5000X location. In case of when condition is false, for example, here we have this segment of program in which we have used jump if not 0 means JNZ instruction. According to previous example, value of 0 flag is 1, and if I am using JNZ instruction, so it will check value of Z flag, and according to this OP code, 0 flag should be 0, but actually value of Z flag is 1, so condition is false and control will transfer to next instruction instead of 5000 location. Let's see machine control instructions. First, NOP means no operation. When this instruction is executed, microprocessor will not perform any task. It is used for the creation of delay, means no flags are affected during the execution of NOP instruction. The instruction is used to fill in the time delay or to delete and insert instructions while troubleshooting. Second is HLT means halt. When this instruction will execute, further increment of the program counter will stop. It means after execution of halt instruction, execution of program will terminate. Third, disable interrupt is used when the execution of a code sequence cannot be interrupted. For example, in critical time delays, this instruction is used at the beginning of the code and the interrupts are enabled at the end of the code. The 8085 TRAP cannot be disabled. And last one is reset. After a system is reset or the acknowledgement of an interrupt, the interrupt enabled, the flip-flop is reset, thus disabling the interrupts. That's all for today's session. Here are some questions for you. First one, give examples of branch instruction. Give symbolic notation of unconditional jump instruction. If value of Z flag is 1, then which mnemonic code will be used of conditional jump instruction? State true or false. In conditional jump instructions, when condition is false, the control of program is transferred to very next instruction. Thank you for watching this video. Please like, share and subscribe our channel.